Now we want to combine both inputs to filter our gallery. Let's see how this can be done. Let's remember that in the gallery we have the filter using the dropdown search by department. And previously we have done the filter using the search. It's commented here. And now we want to combine both. First, let's remember how this text search was done. Look at the formula here. We can see that we have the search function, then the data source, the input text that the user was going to type, that's called txt name, in our case is this one, right? And then we have the columns that we want to search against. See, as the data source we have TB contact, but instead of having TB contact as the data source, now we are going to consider the whole filter formula as the data source. And this is going to replace the TB contact. That means that now this filter function is the new data source. It's considered as our data source, that means the table filtered with some expressions, but it's still the table. We just added some expressions in the filter. So basically we are going to filter and then we are going to search on this result, on this filter result. In order to do that, I'm going to uncomment the search function. Now, let's just break a couple of lines here so it's easier to understand the formula. And we see that this is the part we need to replace, the TB contact, with this filter. So I'm going to select the filter, Ctrl X to cut, and then I'm going to replace this part that I just highlighted with Ctrl V. Just ident this, and then we can see that now this is the first argument of the search function, meaning that this is the data source. And the remaining part stays the same. Let's play the app and see if it works. Okay, now we should be able to filter by department and also search. Let's try doing the search first. Let's see. Clark. We are getting Clark Kent. Okay, the search works in the same way. Let's try filtering by department. Let's see everyone from sales. Okay, selecting sales, we have Clark Kent and Steve Rogers. Now, last thing, we are going to search a name and see if this search will narrow down this result that was the filter by department. Again, let me type Clark. See, now both filters are being applied to our collection, to our gallery, I mean. And now we are going to be able to start looking at forms that are the controls that are going to allow us to create and edit these records. It's going to be a very interesting topic and very important for Power Apps. See you in the next class.